Welcome to Drawing Software. This recording will be our quick start guide. Our intention is to help you become familiar with working with this version and help you get started with the software right away. When the application begins, you always see the Welcome tab. This tab gives you easy access to resources and lets you to quickly complete common tasks. For instance, you can easily create a new design using just the blank canvas, or you can load any existing designs. Likewise, you can import any image or embroidery design into a new design. For example, old embroidery designs or artwork files like photos or vector images. The design browser can help you navigate and locate designs or various artwork sources. Click on any design to load it. Import embroidery files. Or artwork files. As you can see, any design you create or open is loaded onto a new tab, so you can easily navigate through the loaded designs just by clicking on the different tabs, while you can always switch back to the Welcome tab. To open any of the recent designs, you can just use this list. Use this slider to change the size of the preview icons or switch back to Details view. Now, through the Welcome tab, you can also select the default embroidery machine and the default hoop. Additionally, you may select a default fabric for each new design. The fabric selection is crucial because the software automatically optimizes the embroidery according to the fabric type. If you are not particularly familiar with the use of the software, you may refer to the user guide or view any of the training video tutorials. Click to go to all videos and search through all sections. Now, for any design, even if you load an existing one or start a new blank design, you start with the design area in the middle and the tools bar on the left. This toolbar holds most of the design tools and working modes. So you have normal selection mode, the node editor mode, where you can edit the shape of a design, the stitch editor, the digitize tools with which you may create any shape you like. And here are the ready-made shapes. We will not go into detail about all the available tools at this point, but let me just show you the basic routines. One thing you should know is that most of the icons are like working modes. When selecting them, you get into a mode where you may only perform the selected action. For example, when starting edit nodes, you may only change the shape of an object. Likewise, when you start digitize tools, you may create shapes until you release the tool. So when entering a certain mode, you can perform only the selected action. When you are done, you can switch to rectangle selection mode, where you can manage all created parts, or go to any other working mode you like. Another important thing is that the software is context sensitive. This means that when you select a certain design part, the particular options of the toolbars dynamically change according to the selected design part. For instance, you can see the size properties on tool options bar and transform them by using numeric values. You may edit a design's properties on the properties bar. You may edit the colors, You can also edit using the mouse. The object properties appear only when an object is selected. Other tools also appear only when they can be applied, like the align tools. The align tools appear when more than two objects are selected. One more thing we need to mention is that the available tools and options of these toolbars change dynamically according to the techniques you enable for each design. The available techniques are cut, embroidery, stencil, crystals, and paint. So always have in mind that a tool or an option may not be available with some of the enabled techniques, while it may be available in other techniques. For example, if you choose the cut technique, the cut outline type appears. If you enable the crystals technique, you only get to see the options that have to do with filling your design with crystals. Have in mind, though, that you can simultaneously enable more than one technique. The design routine is simple. You can easily import artwork into your design. Transform using your mouse. Change stitch types by a single click. Create new parts using the available tools, like these stars using the shape tool. Change colors. Transform using numeric values. And many, many more options which are presented in separate videos. When you're satisfied with the design you created, you can easily send it to your machine for production. Enjoy creating!